Mario has asked, how lean can you go before causing damage? It's not actually a case necessarily of the lean air fuel ratio causing damage. And what we'll find if we take things to the extremes are the likes of the LMP1 prototype engines, they actually run on the lean side of stoic, even given that they are heavily boosted. So the lean air fuel ratio in and of itself does not necessarily mean that we are going to do damage. What it does do though is it raises the combustion charge temperature. More often than not, the actual damage from the lean air fuel ratio comes from that higher combustion charge temperature resulting in detonation or knock occurring, and it's the knock that actually does the real damage. So there's a few considerations there. Obviously, we want to be monitoring for detonation, and a leaner air fuel ratio is likely going to need us to retard the ignition timing to stay safe. Also, if we do want to run a lean air fuel ratio for extended periods of time, it will put more thermal load into the piston, making it expand more. So some considerations around there, around piston cooling as well as our piston to cylinder wall clearance, that we'd need to take into account to ensure reliability. That question was taken from one of our free live lessons. If you like free stuff and you're the type of guy who wants to expand your knowledge, click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson. You'll learn about performance engine building and EFI tuning, and you'll also have the chance to ask your own questions, which I'll be answering live. Remember, it's 100% free, so follow the link to claim your spot.